Technology really affects our brains in multiple ways, and it's something that's been happening for decades, really. The first actually has to deal with our ability to concentrate. What happens when we think we're multitasking is we're really task switching very, very quickly. So your attention goes from one thing to another so rapidly that you don't really think about it. You think you really are splitting your attention. And instead, it's just a very cognitively taxing process to keep going back and forth. It tires us out and it makes us less able to concentrate on one thing. So it actually does lower your attention span. We have this wonderful thing called Google, and it's great. You can look anything up, and you can look it up basically instantaneously. But what happens to memory? If your brain knows that it can look it up, it doesn't actually retain the information. So things that you read online, unless you make a conscious effort to remember them, you're going to forget them. What you'll remember instead is how to find them again. What technology does is it's this constant hot trigger because it makes our environment aligned with that desire to have our brain flit from thing to thing. Basically, it gets us at our weakest point, and it really feeds into that not very good for us desire. It's like junk food, basically. There was a really fascinating study that had college students sit alone in a room for 20 minutes, and their phones were taken away, and they couldn't do anything. There weren't any books. There was nothing like that, and they just had to sit there. And they were miserable. They just couldn't do it. They wanted to get out of there. And then afterwards, when they were asked to say, you know, would you rather do this again or get a series of electric shocks, most of them said, I want electric shocks. I actually want something bad done to me rather than having to sit in a room with my own thoughts, because we've really gotten out of the habit of doing that. I don't think we need to be afraid of technology. I think we should embrace it, but we really need to be aware of what it can do, and in that way we can try to kind of embrace the good about technology and yet try to keep our brains developing in the direction we want them to develop.
Hi, click down there to like and subscribe. I do it myself, but I'm a rock.